Welcome to video 11 in the series Learning Finance. Here, gradually, now we are moving into a discussion on financial statements. But before I do that, let's quickly talk about what kind of information people need from financial statements, because only then looking at financial statements would make more sense for us. So let's look at who are the typical users and what their expectations are. So first set of people who always like to look at financial data are investors as well as likely investors. What is that they're looking for? They're looking for examining what is the kind of profits that the company is making, are they sustainable, how strong is the company from a financial position perspective. Of course, in later videos, we are going to understand all this in terms of how to assess that, but right now I'm just sharing their expectations. The other thing which is very important is what is the strength of cash flows. When we run our own family, we also watch our movement of cash, how much money is coming in and going out. A company also needs to look at that, and we are going to see this in detail in later video. But what is the strength of operating cash flows is something that investors always look for. Then there are lenders who want to lend money. There could be banks, financial institutions, there could be other institutional lenders who may be interested. They may be domestic, they may be foreign, but they have also certain expectations from the company, and they always look at the financial statements to check whether those expectations are likely to be fulfilled. So one of the important decisions that they are required to take is whether to lend at all, and if that is the case, how much to lend. Very important aspect that lenders look at is, does the company have ability to pay off its dues and interest? Otherwise, you lend money and later on you want to recover your money, it becomes difficult, and we've seen umpteen examples of that. So this is something that lenders always look at. Also, what are the factors that may impact the company's ability to pay? They have taken the loan, they are obliged to pay interest, they are obliged to repay the loan. But are they able to do it? And what are those factors which may actually impact the company's ability to pay, looking at its own financial position? So this aspect also needs to be looked at, and lenders do look at it. Then the other set of stakeholders are employees. Even employees are very wise today. They are always looking for career prospects when they join an employer. So only that organization which has a very strong financial position, which has sustainable profitability, or at least the prospects of going into very high levels of profitability, would be the only company which can provide great career prospects over a long period of time to employees. And naturally, employees are always looking at a company's financial data from that perspective. Then how much is likely to be the pay rise also depends on the ability of the company to generate profits, and the same thing is applicable for variable pay also. Quite often companies offer limited fixed pay, but they offer a lot of incentives to variable payment. Variable payment is something which is dependent on the company's profits, that particular business segment's profit, that individual performance, and there are many parameters which are applied to distribute variable pay. But we must admit that only if a company is sufficiently profitable that employees can enjoy good variable pay, irrespective of howsoever well they have been performing. The next set of users of financial statements are vendors. So vendors, when they supply goods to us, quite often they give us credit, they give us time to make payment. But then they have to be assured of the timely payment. And they will obviously look at whether the company has the ability to make payment of their bills on time, because otherwise, their own cash flows will suffer. And we are going to discuss these aspects later on. So from their own cash flow management perspective, they have to also be watchful that whether the payment will be timely or whether there will be delays because of stressed financial position of the customer. So how much credit to give to the customer and how much is the duration of that credit, and once having given that credit, what is the likelihood of payment of dues on time? All these aspects are being looked at by vendors today. And quite often, vendors themselves could be large companies, and they naturally are very watchful. Then customers are the next stakeholders who are also looking at the vendor's financial statements. What is their prime interest? Their prime interest is whether the vendor company is financially stable. Because the customer places an order on the vendor and the vendor goes belly up, then the customer's business may also suffer. And that's why before placing an order on a vendor, before getting into a relationship, customers also often are very cautious to look at the financial position, and they monitor it on an ongoing basis also. So essential issue for them is could the customers rely on the vendor for timely delivery also, because the vendor organization may survive for years, but because they are stressed in cash flow aspects or some other challenges, whether the vendor will be able to deliver the material on time. This is something also is of their interest. Tax authorities. What tax authorities look for is whether the company's tax payout is consistent with financial statements. In fact, over a period of time, the tax laws also align with, you know, the reality which they find with companies. So in the 90s, for example, in India, the tax authorities, the government realized that taking advantage of tax provisions, while the companies were declaring handsome profits as far as shareholders were concerned, when it came to tax payout to the government, the tax payout was very little. Not that they were defrauding the government, but they were postponing those taxes. And in fact, at a later stage, I'll also talk about the concept of deferred tax, which was introduced as an accounting requirement as a sequel to this phenomena that the government found in India, that people, the companies were not paying off taxes, but they were declaring handsome profits, showing zero tax payout. The other thing which was also happening was in those days was the companies were not reporting the tax liability which is going to arise in future. They may not be paying any taxes right now, but because of those tax provisions, there will be certain obligation which will arise down the line. So some corrective action the government had to take. So the essence of what I'm saying here is that the company's tax payout, whether it's consistent with financial performance, is something that the taxman always looks at. Today, employee unions have also become very wise. They are looking for negotiation opportunities based on profitability. They also watch sustainability issues from financial perspective, and therefore, today positively many unions are also looking at working closely with the management in case they also feel that there are some sustainability issues in the long term. They are willing to look at solutions together with the management. That's a very positive trend. So friends, I hope you got a good idea in terms of how different users of financial statements are looking for different kinds of data. Now this, I hope, was a good prelude for our discussion on financial statements, which are going to follow soon. So do press subscribe button, or even better, save the Learning Finance playlist to your library, or you can create your own playlist depending on those videos that you think are very important. Thank you.